Revu 2019 empowers you to gain full control of your next quantity takeoff by delivering the accuracy and efficiency you need. Using an incorrect scale in a project can lead to rework and lost productivity. So Revu 2019 features intuitive functionality that makes sure you have the correct scale set for your entire document. This allows you enhanced control of measurement properties, like independent units, as well as running totals to keep you up to date on your projects, all in a newly optimized interface. Revu 2019 ensures accuracy by allowing you easier and more visible options for controlling scale on your drawings. The scale can be seen and set in targeted areas on the interface to avoid any potential mistakes. The Measurements panel has been updated to prominently feature the scaling options for your document, either through calibrating or entering a custom scale or preset from the drop-down menu. This panel also includes measurement property options and the ability to add and edit viewports using the new scale functionality. Another major change for the measurement properties is that the markup type selected will determine what properties will be shown in the measurements panel. If there are multiple markups selected, all of the common properties for those markups will display, and editing them will change all of their values. Another update to the measurements panel is the presence of options for measurements and display in the measurements menu. You can show or hide the tools in the panel and check the option to make all measurements annotations, or simply use them for review. You can also select snaps for measurement tools and choose whether viewports are highlighted in these options. The scale for each page is displayed in the thumbnails panel under the thumbnail, making it easier to see what each scale is and can be toggled on and off in the panel menu. It will say Scale Not Set to alert you if the page does not have a scale set. You can also change the scale by double-clicking on it here. The scale is also shown in the navigation bar, with the same message if the scale is not set. Clicking on this area will likewise allow you to set the scale. The options for setting the scale of your documents allows for more specific control for more accurate measurements. Clicking on one of the scale options offers a prompt to either calibrate from a measurement in the document or enter the scale directly. Choose Calibrate and directions will appear on how to calibrate, which you can choose to hide for later calibrations. Click OK and you will need to select two points of a known measurement. Once you've taken the initial measurement, the Calibrate dialog will appear. Here, you'll see the literal measurement you took in the first box under Custom. You would then enter in the measurement that distance represents in the next entry field. In the drop-downs below, you can control the precision of the resultant measurement and the range of pages the scale is applied to. If you choose Custom for page range, you will need to type that range into the field. If you select the input option for setting the scale, a similar dialog appears without needing a calibration measurement, prompting you to either select a preset option based on industry standards from the dropdown, or select custom and input the scale you need. You can then edit the precision and page range as well. These updates also help to avoid rework and lost productivity that occurs when a scale has not yet been set. When you are measuring on a document and a scale has not been defined, Revu will prompt you to enter a scale using one of the methods you've just seen. Note that Revu will delete the measurement if a scale is not set. The Properties toolbar has also been updated to allow additional control of measurement units as well as displaying running measurement totals. Clicking on the Units menu items allow you to define units in your measurement. You can set independent units for area and volume to allow for differences between the output totals, which can be useful for things like estimating materials of different types. You also have access to modifying properties like depth, slope, or rise-drop, which will be presented when a measurement that could use one of these properties is selected. Entering in these properties changes the calculation of the measurement to account for 3D measurements on a 2D plan. Once input, the measurement updates automatically to reflect the true measurement in a 3D space. Entering a depth, for example, allows you to perform volume and wall area calculations by providing that additional measurement, where rise-drop accounts for vertical runs in wiring and piping. Measurement totals have also been added to the properties toolbar, showing the total of all measurements currently selected on the drawing. This function allows the user to see totals that might be useful within their current workflow. This menu can be detached and placed in a convenient place on your display for easier access to those totals, and reattached in its typical location just as easily.